I'm going to show you how you can create stunning AI-generated images using the hottest generator in town. Yep, I'm talking about Flux AI. And the best part? You don't need any technical skills. There is no complex UI. And I'll show you how you can do this on a budget. In fact, I'll show you how you can get started for free. Whether you want to spice up a presentation, create art for your business, your marketing campaigns, your learning initiatives, or your website, or you're just trying to have some fun, I'll show you how easy it is to get started with Flux AI. Let's roll. So what's the big deal about Flux? Flux is an open source AI image generator developed by Black Forest Lab, a team consisting of former Stability AI employees. Yep, I'm talking about the same people who brought us Stable Diffusion. So why should you care about Flux when there are other big name AI image generators like Midjourney or DALL-E? Well, Flux excels in many different areas, including photorealism. It can generate detailed, visually rich images with simple prompts. It can even handle detailed tasks like text and images, or what most AI struggle with, hands. Perfect hands, great at text, and great at photorealism? Sign me up. Another unique feature offered by Flux that's not available in Midjourney is that you can create uncensored content. That doesn't mean you can create not safe for work content, but it does mean that you can create images with famous logos or famous people. Well, by the end of this video, you're going to know how to use Flux AI to create stunning images without having to spend hours learning new tools, and all that without breaking the bank. Yep, I'm showing you how to use Flux using Replicate. We'll even take a look at Flux's performance on photorealistic images, on text within images, and we'll see how it does with hands. So let's roll. Okay, here's Forest Lab's website. If you scroll down, you can see some images that were created by Flux AI. And I gotta say, I am super impressed by these images. Just take a look. Look very realistic, and the text on these images it's good. There are a number of different places where you can access Flux AI. You can find it on Hugging Face, Replicate, FreePic, Vivid AI, TensorArt, SegMind, lots of different options. Today we're going to look at how you can use it using Replicate, because that makes it really simple, easy to use, and you can get started in no time. All right, let's get started. You're gonna head over to the Black Forest Labs website and then click Get Flux. Once you're there, you can click the Replicate icon to head on over to Replicate, where you'll be able to access the Flux models. You can log in using your GitHub account. If you don't have one, you can create one for free. And once you're done that, you're all set. Yep, no complicated download or install required. They'll ask you to put in your billing information because there is a cost associated with using this model, but it's a really good value for what you're paying for. And a little later in the video, I'll actually show you how you can get started for free. You can quickly search for Flux using the search bar. Now, Flux offers three main models. Flux Pro, this is the high-end, professional quality images, perfect for commercial use. It's the most expensive option. Flux Dev is that middle tier. You'll get great value for the amount that you're spending. And Flux Chanel. Flux Chanel is the fastest, cheapest option, but the quality of images may not be that great. For beginners, I recommend you start off with Flux Dev. It'll give you a chance to experiment without spending as much, and you'll still get really great quality images. And that's what we're doing today. I'll click Flux Dev and we'll get started with that. It's great for playing around, and it's not really going to hurt your wallet. If you've used tools like Stable Diffusion or any other image generation tool, this is gonna feel like second nature to you. But if you're a complete beginner, don't worry. I'm here to guide you step by step so you can get started on creating images in no time. The first thing you'll see is the input section on the left side of your screen. Here you can enter your prompt, basically a description of the image that you want Flux to create for you. A simple tip, the more specific you are, the better your generation will be. Feel free to describe colors, textures, lighting, or specific objects to really guide Flux to create that image that you have in mind. This is perhaps your most important section. Once you've got that, you can actually go ahead and generate just like that. Now, under the prompt section, you'll find some adjustable settings. As a beginner, you can leave these as is. The default settings are great to get started. But if you want more control over the image, you can tweak them. So right below, you'll see the aspect ratio. The aspect ratio controls the shape of your image. You could ask for a 1:1 ratio, which is going to get you a nice square, or you can ask for a 16:9 to get that widescreen rectangle shape. The shape you choose really depends on what you want to use the image for, whether you're using it to create a video or you're using it as a logo. It really depends on what you want to use it for. Under the aspect ratio, you'll see the option to upload an image. You can use this option if you're trying to create an image-to-image generation. Under that, you've got the prompt strength. You can use this for image-to-image generations to control the prompt strength, with 1 being the maximum and 0 being the minimum. Now, under that, you can choose the number of outputs. The default is 1, but you can choose up to 4, which is similar to the results that you'd see in Midjourney. And then you've got the number of inference steps. The recommended range is 28 to 50. I would leave that as the default, which is 28. And then you've got the guidance number, which is currently set at 3.5. To get started, I would leave that as 3.5. You've also got the option to add in a seed. So as a beginner, I would say to leave that as is. You can also choose the output format. So now, once you've decided on all the settings, and like I said, as a beginner, you can leave most of them on default. And once you get a hang of Flux, you can start adjusting for your needs. Once you've adjusted your settings, you'll click run and an image will be generated for you by Flux. But before we do that, let's talk money, because that's important. Replicate is great because it only charges you for the compute time, which is the time it takes the AI to generate the image. And it's pennies per image, so it's super affordable. The model is based on how much it generates. If you scroll down, you'll see the pricing structure, and you'll see if you want to generate 100 images, 100 images are only going to cost you $3. That's $3 American. So it's super affordable. Now, I did say that I'll show you how you can get started for free. Well, Matt Wolf shared a link that you can use to get $10 that you can use on Replicate, and you can use those to get started on Flux. I'll share a link to that in the description below. I use the same link and I was able to get $10 to use towards generating my own images. Thanks, Matt. This is great. With 100 images costing only $3, this is going to give you a good start. All right, now we're familiar with the interface, it's time to start creating. Let's put in our first prompt and see how great of a job Flux really does. I'm sure you've come across those trendy images people are making with Flux, with the portrait of a person with the word Flux on their face. So we'll try to create one of those. Here's my prompt, and we'll scroll down and pick an aspect ratio of 16:9 because I want that widescreen image, and I'll go ahead and click run. And I am looking forward to what we're going to get. Okay, it's good, but it's not the best. So I'm gonna run it one more time. All right, now we're talking. This looks great. I love how the word Flux doesn't look like it's just sitting on top. It actually looks like it's been written on her skin. Flux did a really great job. It looks very realistic. What do you think? Once you're happy with the image, you can click on it to download it, or you can click the download button to download the image. Okay, we see that Flux is good, but how good is it? Let's put it to the test. Let's run some tests to see if Flux really lives up to its hype. We'll test it on its ability to create photorealistic images. We'll also test how well it does when creating text within images. And lastly, we'll look at how it does with hands. Let's see. Let's start off with creating a photorealistic image with a lot of detail. I used ChatGPT to help me come up with these images so that we could really test how well Flux does. So let's see. Okay, what do you think? Is it doing a good job? I think it is. It's a really great picture of an elderly woman with wrinkles, soft natural light, realistic skin texture, gray hair. It followed the prompt, and the realism on this picture is pretty fantastic. Let's try a couple others. Here's a close-up of a golden retriever in the rain. Golden retriever looks very realistic. However, the rain, I mean, I can see a few droplets there, but not the best. Okay, here's an image of a photo of a busy New York street at night with reflections on the wet pavement. Okay, I am liking this. It really captured the reflection and this photo looks quite realistic. Although the cars are going a little bit all over the place, but it's still done pretty well. I would say though, the buildings are a little too perfect. That does give it that artificial AI look. So is it good? Yes. Is it perfectly photorealistic? You must have seen the other trendy images created by Flux, which is of a person at a conference. And people have been showing some really great results with this. So let's try that out. Okay, I've got a young woman smiling while speaking on stage, white background with corporate logos blurred out that read subscribe, tech conference, extreme realism, photorealistic. Let's look at the results. Okay, did a great job. Look at this person's hand. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yep, we got 10 fingers. No more than that. It did a good job with the text logo in the background as well. One of the coolest features of Flux AI is its ability to generate great text with an image that looks like it's part of that image. So let's put that to the test and see how well Flux really does. Now we'll see how well Flux does with something most AI generators have been absolutely struggling with, hands.
Okay, there you go. Now you know how to use Flux AI on Replicate. It's super easy, it's very beginner friendly, and you can use the link provided below to get started for free. Shout out again to Matt Wolf for the link. You'll get $10 free to use on Replicate, and you can use that to get started, get yourself familiar with Flux, and start creating images and see what you think. Replicate is super cheap to use, and it's a really great option if you don't want to invest in a subscription and you just want to pay as you go. It's a great tool to create photorealistic images, text within images, and it's pretty great with hands. So definitely recommend. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to click subscribe. We've got lots more on AI tools coming your way. I'll see you in the next video.